Hello students, we study here a new topic, that is ultrafiltration. I have already studied in the earlier topic that the kidney perform a role. The role is called that is the formation of urine, and kidney perform a role that filter the blood and remove the toxic substances from the body. The main toxic substance of the kidney that is our blood is that is the urea. Urea is that is mixed within the blood. The kidney filter the blood. Kidney filter the blood. The process by which kidney filter the blood is called ultrafiltration. Ultrafiltration is the process by which kidney filter the blood. That is the kidney filter blood by ultrafiltration. Second thing is that is the artery which transfers blood to kidney. That is called renal artery. These are the renal artery that transfer blood to the kidney. And these kidney have, that is these artery, that is divided into different type of small arterioles. That is called, that is a small part of the artery is called arterioles. Then the kidney contains, all kidney have, that is two kidney present in our abdominal cavity. And kidney contains, that is the millions of nephrons. Nephrons is also called uriniferous tubules. These nephrons are the filtration unit. The nephrons present within the kidney, and these kidney nephrons is the filtration unit. And these that is the nephrons called uriniferous tubules. The process by which kidney filter the blood is called ultrafiltration. What happened in ultrafiltration? The renal artery that transfer blood to kidney. You see here the kidney. In the my flow chart, you see here renal artery transfer blood to kidney. And kidney filter blood and remove the urea. You see here urea. Then the urea that mix with water, then it is called urine. And this urine was filtered by uriniferous tubules. And that is the by filtration, it that is collected in urinary bladder. That the kidney that is transfer the blood with a that is tube-like structure that is called ureter. And ureter that is transfer the blood in that is urinary bladder. This urinary bladder that is a bladder-like structure by which time blood removed from the that is our body. So these are the process by which ultrafiltration occurs. The process is difficult because there is everything dissolved in the blood, and blood has capacity. Everything dissolved in the blood, then we have to save all everything except the blood. So the blood is only we kidney filter the toxic substances. Everything mixed in the blood, so the process is difficult that the extra substances, that is harmful substances, filtered by the kidney. Here, that is these are the structures of nephrons. These nephrons are filled within the kidney. The kidney has two parts. One part is called, that is cortex, another part is medulla. The artery which transfers the blood from heart to kidney, that is called renal artery. Renal artery divided into many arterioles. That is, these are the arterioles which enter in the nephrons. That is called afferent arterioles. Such type of tube-like structure, that is called tubules. Nephrons is called uriniferous tubules. And these are broader tubules, that is called collecting duct. These are many nephrons are open within this. These are the many nephrons open within this, and the collecting duct transfer the filtrate into the ureter. The collecting duct have many nephrons are linked such way. I am describing you only one nephrons, how they filter. The system for filtration for all nephrons are same way. No any separate system. A common system for that is the filtration of the blood. Then you see here the arterioles which transfer blood to that is the uniferous tubules. These are a funnel-like structure called glomerulus, that is called Bowman capsules. A funnel-like structure, that is called Bowman capsule. And here is a bunch of that is artery, that is called glomerulus. The wall of the glomerulus is very thin, and the blood enters through a pressure by afferent arterioles. Then what happens? These are that is enter here, and the afferent arteriole is that is narrower than afferent arteriole. Then pressure increases in glomerulus. What happens? There is a, something is filtered within this, and these filtrates enter to the glomerulus. Then they enter to this, and this is called GF. GF. Glomerular filtrate. GF is the glomerular filtrate. And these filtrates that is enter to the Henle loop, make a loop line that is Henle loop, and then they open into collecting that. The glomerular filtrates have a lot of useful substance also present in these filtrates. But these filtrates again reabsorb by peritubular network. Here is the peritubular network by which these are that is again reabsorbed. Again that is substance which is useful, reabsorbed by peritubular network. So these are the system reabsorption. Because GF is glomerular filtrate is greater than the urine. That is these are reabsorbed again substance which is useful, water, everything that absorbed by that is peritubular network. And these are the system by which that is the urea, water and something is that is filtered by glomerulus. And these glomerulus, the filtrate is enter in that is the Bowman capsule, and they enter into with the Henle loop and enter in the collecting duct. The system by which that is the useful substances is that is the present in the blood. These blood are filtered blood. The filter afferent arteriole, that also is the filtered blood. And these are that is the filtration. Filtrate is called glomerular filtrate. Which one that is the filtered by that is the these Bowman capsule and glomerulus, that is called GF glomerular filtrate. They produce some useful substance also available in these filtrate. Then again reabsorb. That process is called reabsorption. Reabsorption. The process is called reabsorption. Then again reabsorb, and they collected in collecting duct, that is collecting duct, and these collecting duct open into ureter. Ureter is a tube-like structure, and ureter open into the urinary bladder. The system by which that is these nephrons filter the blood is called ultrafiltration. They remove toxic substances and that is extra water, extra anything that is present in the blood was filtered by that is the glomerulus. The glomerulus filters all every extra thing which is available in the blood, because the pH of blood is 7.4, viscosity of the blood 4.7. So everything maintains water balance, pH balance, salt balance. So everything is fixed in the blood. Then the everything is extra in the blood. Then it is filtered by kidney. And also urea. Urea is a toxic substance. These was filtered by kidney and make urine. Urine is that is the water solution of urea. Urine is the solution of water. That is it have a urea and that is the water. The color of urine yellow. Color is the yellow color. Why it is yellow? Because urochrome pigment present in the urine. So the color of urine is yellow. That are these are yellow color with the presence of urochrome, and urine is the secretory substances that are removed by a process. The process is called ultrafiltration. Blood 20 kidney perform their role, filter blood 24 hours and remove the toxic substances, extra substances, maintain homeostasis. The homeostasis is also maintained by kidney. The internal environment of the body is maintained by the kidney. Kidney perform a major role for filtration, and that is removal of toxic substances. The filtration unit which is present in kidney is called nephron. It is the structures of nephron that is a very important thing by which the kidney filter is called ultrafiltration.